In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a beat with Logic Pro X. And I'll be using Logic Pro 10.5.1 as the most recent version to date of Logic Pro X. My promise to you is that by the end of this video, you'll have hopefully a much stronger understanding of how to actually make a beat. And we're not just talking strictly about electronic beats, but if you're actually a singer-songwriter or you're into folk music or whatever, how do you make drums when you're not a drummer? And how do you put drums and beats into your tracks and your music? By the way, quick mention, if at the end of the video you're wanting to know more about Logic Pro X and how to record acoustic instruments and vocals and a bit more of an extensive course on Logic Pro X, I do have that. It's about an hour and a half long, and it's really a full free course on my YouTube channel. I'll leave a link in the description. You can check that out if you'd like. So the three or four ways that we can make a beat, and we'll go through each of these ways in this video, are to actually use our MIDI controller and record the beats as we play them. The second way is to actually draw or paint the notes in right inside the DAW with Logic Pro X, and we'll go through that way too. And then the third way is using drum loops and audio loops that Logic Pro X gives you for free. And the fourth way is using kind of a mix of all of these ways. And so we'll do that as well. Let's do the first way though, where we're actually going to start a software instrument track and use our MIDI controller to actually record a beat as we play it. So here I am in Logic Pro X with an empty window and I have a software instrument added. And this is instrument one. This is the default software instrument that Logic Pro X gives you. And so we're not gonna be using this because this is a synth, as we can see. So we're gonna wanna choose a drum sound that we like. This can be an electronic drum sound, or this can be like a typical rock singer-songwriter drum set. It's up to you on how you want to sound like, and it doesn't really matter at the beginning because we're recording in MIDI. We'll have the chance to switch that after we've recorded our actual pattern, and then we can choose the different sounds we like. And how we're going to get there is through the drum kit designer. If we want the more electronic drum kit sounds, we're going to go to the bottom here to the drum machine designer. So let's first look at the drum kit designer. We'll go stereo, and then we'll look through the different drum kits that Logic has. And so you see the picture of it here, and this is the factory default that's loaded up. And then we can go down here to all the different drum kits that are available, and you'll notice that these drum kits here are the same as these drum kits on the side. And so those are the stock drum kits that Logic gives us. So if we go to this sunset kit, this is what it actually looks like, and then I can go over to my MIDI keyboard here and play this kit. So I'm just kind of playing notes, looking for things. And then you can play exactly what you want to play and record it in. And that's what we're going to do. Let's say we don't want this natural drum sound. This is what the electronic kit sounds like. We'll just press in these top and bottom arrows to switch our instrument and go down to the drum machine designer. And this is where we can get typical kind of 808 sounds, more electronic style instruments. If we just X this and then go to our electronic drum kit here, here we have different libraries of kits. And the ones that are grayed out, I just don't have those actually downloaded natively on my computer. The ones that are in white are downloaded as the library of sounds. So this 808 Flex is a drum kit. Here we go. So kind of cool, right? Actually, it's a nice sound. The one thing you're going to want to keep in mind is the tempo of the song, because you will want to get a lead-in click by pressing this 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll want to have the metronome on here. Right now I have this set at 105. Let's do something even right now at, maybe something a little slower, 100. And that will be... So that's a good little tempo to start a beat. I'm gonna record, and by pressing R on my keyboard, or this little red dot here. So super simple, right? And we don't have to get overcomplicated. We can make things more complicated and more complex later by adding elements. Now we're gonna draw and paint the beat in with Logic. So how we're gonna wanna do that is we'll make some space here by removing this library on the side by clicking this little folder, and then we're gonna double click on the 808 here to open up the editor. So what we're gonna wanna do now is quantize our beat and then make it a little better, clean it up and maybe add some things so it sounds a bit more interesting. How we're gonna wanna quantize is because I did eighth notes on the hi-hat, I'm gonna want to Command A and then quantize over here. If I just make some space, I can see quantize by 1/8 notes and then press the Q. And that's locked everything in place with the notes here by 1/8 notes. And you can see all the hi-hat notes here are falling nicely on the grid. And 1/8 notes means that there's actually 8 hi-hat notes here in one bar. This one bar has 8 hi-hat notes. How we're gonna wanna make this beat a little more interesting now is we have a few different options. We can use what we call the pencil tool or the paintbrush tool. And your tools are up here by these dropdowns. And the tool on the right, you can quickly get to this tool just by holding down Command, and that will turn into this tool. So it is pencil here. If I switch that to the glue tool, and if I press Command, it will be the glue. So I'm gonna have the pencil tool on the right side here, and then on the left side, I'm going to have the default tool, which is gonna be my paintbrush tool. And so you'll see I have paintbrush, and then I can press Command to get to pencil. And those tools, you can quickly erase, add things, and extend different MIDI notes to get the beat that you like as quickly as possible. And with the paintbrush tool, you can just be typing in anywhere on the grid, and it's gonna give you these different sounds. With the pencil tool, it's very similar to the paintbrush tool, but it gives us a little more flexibility when we go Command. When we go Command and have the pencil, we can be clicking to have notes, but we can also be dragging notes to have different lengths. I guess 3 or 4 standard and most important elements that you would have in a beat are the kick, the hi-hats, and the snare. And that's what I have here. That's kind of the main ingredients to a beat. And then, of course, you have a lot of different percussive elements. You have toms, you have rides and crashes and tambourines and many different elements that can make up a great beat. But a beat without a kick, a snare, or a clap, and hi-hats, you will be listening to, I guess, maybe bongo types, Southern Caribbean music. Right away, we can layer our kicks if we want them to sound fatter. Not maybe on everyone, but maybe on, for example, the 2 and the 4. And so what I mean by that is we have, on the left side here, we have all the elements in our kicks in our 808 kick package that we can test with. So we see we have the down here, we have the kick 1, but we also have this sub kick. So the sub kick might be nice to go maybe beat 2 and 4. So let's hear what that sounds like. And let's add a clap on the snare hits. And we can also add claps, maybe a clap here and a clap here on the first and third snare hits. The best way to learn this stuff is actually just by adding things and seeing what sounds good and what doesn't sound good. Two things I'd like to do when I hit a wall and can't find any more ideas are to change the tempo of the track. Because we're in MIDI, we can have the flexibility to do that. And because we are in MIDI, we can also change the sound of the drums as well. So let's say I'm like, I'm already in it, and I'm kind of like, this is an all right beat. What I might do is actually speed this up to 110 at the top here, and then I might change the sound by opening up our library again and then going to maybe analog circuits. That's gonna load up a new kit, and we've already changed our tempo to 110, so we'll be sound quite different. That's cool. So I'm gonna add some shakers here. Oops. See, I made a mistake, so I'm just gonna add, just drag on the paintbrush on when it says shaker here to soften out those hi-hats. And now we get maybe another kick, some more kicks. That's a little much there. But you see what I mean. You can quickly start to make a much more interesting beat by adding different elements from different sound packs and changing the tempo. And also, as soon as we start adding synths and pianos and a vocal on this, it's going to fill out the beat and really tie it together. So sometimes a simple beat is all you need at the beginning. And even if you think it's maybe a little bare, that's probably a good sign. We're gonna make a beat now from scratch using drum loops and audio loops that Logic gives us. So we can open up our loop browser here. And right away we can go to kits or all drums, for example, and we can choose different backbeats or you just go through them and take a listen to them. And I'm going to do just something. I like the backbeats that Logic offers, so let's see here. Just turn that down. So I'm going to load that one in, and I'm going to use that as a beat. Let's say I just really like this snare hit. This snare hit here. And I really want that snare hit on maybe the analog circuits beat that I did earlier, or I want to save that as a sample to use somewhere else. And so I can quickly I have the scissors toolbar in my command option here, so I can press command and I can actually just cut this up and have this as a separate sample here of a snare. So I have that as a snare now. And I can use this snare, I can copy and paste this snare wherever I'd like. I can mute this track here that we just had, or I can completely get rid of it. And now I have this snare hit that I could add to my analog circuits. So this is what that would sound like if I added the snare here. And I can just copy and paste these snares, sorry, I put it on the wrong track there, into the right spots where the snares are happening in the track above. And maybe I might not want to have that many snare hits, but that gives you an example of how you can take different elements, not only of the drum loops that Apple gives you, but you can actually cut those up and use samples of them. Another way to make beats and drums in Logic Pro X is to use the drum yellow tracks, I like to call them, that Logic gives us. So let's mute these two tracks, go to our loop browser, and if we go back to drums or kits, you'll notice that some were in blue, and then some of these are in yellow. So these ones are in yellow. Let's go just to the, let's say, exact chorus. And we'll load this one in. And so this is a drum loop that's been made for us. It's a pack from Logic. And then we can edit these presets on quite a deep level. So if we just make some space here, we're closing this. So we can see this if we solo. That's what this drum track sounds like. Under this custom preset. So if we have these different presets here, feedback, four track, no bass, one take, street team, and you're seeing that all these custom elements are changing. So if we go to this three chords preset, we can customize this on how we please based on all these elements that you can actually visualize by looking at the drum set. So if we don't want hi-hats, we just click the hi-hats off. We don't want kick, just click the kick off. If we'd like the kick to this preset and we don't want the kick in our analog circuits, we can go and mute that kick in our analog circuits and use the kick of this kit in the Detroit Garage Zach. So let's take a quick listen to what this sounds like. So, not bad. You can go and customize it here using this kind of quadratic fills. So you can see how you can get quite customized into these presets, because not only do you have this quadratic, but you also have these different option elements for the kick and snare. So you have one up to eight different options of kick and snare patterns that you can match with five different hi-hat options and match with three different percussion elements. Another way to make a beat is something similar to what I did with using the Apple Loops library is to use samples, something like Splice. I use Splice not that much, but I do have it, and so I'm going to show you an example of it. Let's start with using a sample of a kick that we really like, because that's kind of the bread and butter of your beat. And so we're going to use this big kick here. It's a really big kick. So we're going to just drag that into our session. And keep in mind, we have a tempo of 110. Typically, when you're making a beat, you might have a 4 on the floor kick, or like the kicks on the 1 and 3, or the 2 and 4. And now, but really, there's no rules. What sounds good is the best approach to go with. Let's do a 4 on the floor kick. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 kicks in one bar, and we'll do that for each bar. So that's gonna sound a bit aggressive right now, but. So as you can see, the kick is exactly with the metronome. And so we're gonna want to add a clap to that, or some type of snare. I have a clap here in Splice. So I'm gonna add that in, and I'm gonna have the clap on the 2 and 4. Copy and paste these elements to the rest of your track. So let's do it here. And so that's what this is gonna sound like. And we can always be changing, and just like, maybe we don't want the kick here, we can just delete these kicks. Maybe we want that kick that I just deleted, maybe we want that a bit, you know, before here, to add a double click kick here. You know, that sounds cool. So we're starting to make a bit of a house song. I'm going to spend like 5 minutes just on my own here to make this a big, clean this up a bit. So I did have the kick right before on the 4 on the floor, and that sometimes can sound a bit too like house music, too clubby. So I did this kick pattern here, and then added a second kick happening on the bar. So that this is what the kicks sound like. And then I also upped the tempo to 112. If I double click here, I have in the analog circuits drum kit, I have these snares that have tom rolls, and I have these shakers happening in fourths. So that with that, it sounds like this. And I needed something that gave it more rhythm. So I added these hi-hats, which was a sample from the Loop Browser. And I also added a drummer kit from a software drummer yellow track. So normally, like, I would never actually use all these elements that I had explained in this video, but I wanted to do it for the purposes of this video. So with everything, we can sound like this. So, very simple beat, and you kind of want it to sound simple like that, because as soon as here, I have a synth here, then I'm gonna add some sound, and you'll see it's all really all starts to come together when I add some instruments. 1, 2, 3, 4. Feel free to listen to some of my own music. It doesn't really sound like this example I gave you right here. It is on YouTube and Spotify and everything there. And if you want that more extensive course on Logic Pro X, I'll leave a link in the description, and hope to see you in the next video.